Hi guys, it's Pink October, meaning it's National Breast Cancer Awareness Month. It's an annual campaign to raise awareness about breast cancer, which means to raise awareness about the signs and symptoms, the risk factors, how to avoid the risk factors, and the treatments. Everyone with breasts is at risk of developing breast cancer. And when I mean everyone, I mean both male and female. Though most breast cancer occurs in women that are above 50 years old, but in some rare cases, there are things that will increase the chance of young women to have breast cancer, which is usually called the early onset breast cancer. It's important for you to know the risk factors, and when I mean risk factors are usually the causes, so it can help you to prevent it, can help you to plan, and it can help you to catch it early. Because when you do this, there's a 98% chance of passing the 5-year survival rate with early diagnosis. So let's go to the signs and symptoms, shall we? When we're talking about breast cancer, there's some certain things that you should look out for. Number one is the appearance and size. Is it different from the way it was before? Has it increased? Is there redness on the breast? Is there thickening? Is it thick, or there are some certain parts on the breast that are thick? Are the veins on the breast popping out than usual? And are there irritation as well? Number two, are there any lump in the breast that feels different from the other, or are there lump in the both breasts? Is there any swelling or thickening? And when I mean swelling, I mean, are there any swelling under the arm and the armpit area, or around the collarbone, which is around this area? Number three is pain or discomfort around the breast, either of the breast. Okay, it's a pain that has been there before, has been coming and it's been going, or it's a new pain. The last sign is nipple changes. There's going to be changes in the nipple. For example, it's going to be change in shape, going to be bleeding or discharge from the nipple. Is going to be inverted. It's going to be, for example, like a dimple. It's going to be like inside. It's going to like go inward. Do you understand? You can see why monthly self-examination is extremely important. Emphasis on the extremely. Okay, there's an examination that I want you to know. It's actually originated from Lebanon, and it's the best way for you to check yourself at home. First, you press in circles, then you press in lines, and lastly you gently pinch as well. So that examination is called the bread examination. The other way to check for breast cancer is mammogram. Is like an x-ray, and for that, of course, you have to go to the hospital, and that's the best way actually to check for breast cancer. Let's talk about the early onset breast cancer, and these are for the people that are lower than the age of 45. Okay, these are the things that put you on the higher risk of having breast cancer. One is it's often hereditary, and when I say hereditary, most people think that's just from the maternal side. No, both paternal and maternal, especially if you've had one or more relative that has had breast cancer or ovarian cancer in the past. Okay, having your menstruation before the age of 12 is also going to put you on a higher risk of having breast cancer. Next thing that puts you on a higher risk of having breast cancer is having a dense breast. I mean, a breast that has more connective tissue than fatty tissue. So number one, it's even hard to find any tumor. And when it's hard to find any tumor, you know that it is difficult to treat. And when they find it later on, it's always aggressive. Previous history of breast cancer, because when you've had breast cancer in the past, you're most likely to have breast cancer the second time. Also, if you've had any form of radiation therapy to your chest or your breasts, you are also on the higher side of having breast cancer later in the future, especially if you had that therapy before the age of 30. The craziest thing now is some women would get breast cancer without any of these risk factors, and the fact that you might fall under any of these risk factors does not mean that you're even going to get breast cancer. For males, the risk factors are, number one, there's a rare genetic condition in which the body of the male has an extra X chromosome. So now in this case, the body actually makes more estrogen instead of androgen. That's supposed to be for the male sex characters, right? So in that case, there's going to be risks of having breast cancer. Cirrhosis of the liver, which can lead to lower androgen levels and increases the estrogen levels in the body of the male, and that is liver damage. Another risk factors for male is obesity, and the last one is some certain surgeries that have to do with the removal of the testicles, probably like injury or swelling that has to lead to the removal of the testicles. And the removal of the testicles can increase the risk of breast cancer. So enough of all these risk factors, what can cause it, symptoms, signs, all of that. Let's go to the good news, okay? How can you prevent this from happening? How can you lower the risk of you having breast cancer later in the future? One, keeping a healthy weight. I know you guys are already tired of watching exercise. Just keep a healthy weight. Exercise regularly. I'm not saying you should go and overdo all the things, but just make sure that you're not too fat. You know when you feel healthy, you know when your body is healthy. The other steps to prevent breast cancer or to reduce the risk of having breast cancer later in the future is to cut back on your intake of alcohol, or if you can't avoid alcohol totally, just drink in moderation. Make sure you get 7 to more hours of sleep at night. Breastfeed your children if you can. If you are on any hormonal pills, let your doctors know, because there are some contraceptive pills that have been found to increase the risk of breast cancer as well. And finally, make sure you have your first child before the age of 30. We have 5 different types of treatment for breast cancer. The first, which is hormonal, chemotherapy, radiation therapy, surgery, and biological therapy. For surgery, it's just simply how it sounds, the removal of the cancerous tissue. For chemotherapy, it's using medication, could either be oral or IV, to treat breast cancer. For radiational, it's using high energy rays to destroy the cancerous cell. For hormonal therapy, it's blocking cancer cells from getting the hormones that they need to grow. And for biological therapy, finally, it's working with your body immune system to help it fight against cancer cells. For the treatment of breast cancer, doctors from different specialties often come together to work, the surgeons, the medical oncologists, and the radiation oncologist. My name is Adex Omotola. Don't forget to stay hydrated, and thank you for watching.